Lesson 49, Jesus, a Fisher of Men. In today's lesson, we will learn about Jesus calling some fishermen to follow him and become fishers of men. We shall see that spiritual work is greater than physical work, forgiveness of sins is more important than physical healing, and that time need not be wasted on those who are not ready to obey God. When Jesus is swarmed by great crowds of people on the shores of the sea, he gets into a boat and pushes out just a short ways from the shore so he can speak to the entire crowd. It was a makeshift pulpit, but effective for the purpose. I think it pays to be creative in our approach to our work for the Lord and to try and be as effective in our work as we possibly can, so that we can do good for the greatest number of people. This means using some improvisation and careful thought in how we serve God. Jesus tells Peter to let down his nets for a catch of fish, but Peter complains that he had tried all night to catch fish and had caught nothing. Still, Peter does as the Lord asks, and he and his partners catch so much fish that both of their boats were ready to sink. This shows us how important it is to follow the Lord's instruction, even when it does not appear to be what we think is best. So often we excuse away the commands of our Lord because they do not make sense to us. We might not want to pray for our enemies or give to those who ask of us and turn the other cheek, but when we do obey our Lord, we can see that it will bring to us the overflowing blessings of the Lord. Jesus calls Peter and his partners John and James to follow him, and they are all willing to leave their work of fishing to pursue a greater work for God, and that was catching men for Christ. We learn here that spiritual work is always much more important than physical work. We might wonder how these men managed to live and eat when they had no source of income. The scriptures do not tell us much about this, but we know that those who seek God's kingdom first shall not lack any of their basic needs. God has promised to supply those who seek his kingdom first. When Jesus heals a man of his leprosy, he warns the man not to tell others about his healing, but the man reported it widely. Those who heard the news crowded to meet Jesus, so that he decided to escape into the wilderness so he could spend some time in prayer. While there may be much work to do for God, it is always important to take time to pray so that our service for God will always be blessed by God. Some people tried to bring their lame friend to Jesus for healing. The large crowd of people prevented them from being able to enter the house where Jesus was, so they decided to take some of the roofing away and let their friend down by ropes near to where Jesus was. When Jesus saw their faith, he said to the lame man that his sins were forgiven. This upset some who thought Jesus was blaspheming because no one but God had authority to forgive sins. Jesus, knowing their thoughts, healed the lame man in front of them all and proved that he had authority to forgive sins because God's power was working in him to heal. From this story, we learn that a man needs to have his sins forgiven more than he needs healing of his body. Jesus forgave the man first because that was the greatest need in the man's life, and it is the greatest need in our lives as well. When Jesus is invited to the home of a tax collector named Levi, Jesus is found to be eating with many tax collectors and sinners. These were the people who the religious elite hated and would not associate with, so they were indignant with Jesus for eating with these sinners. Jesus said to them that it was not the healthy who needed a doctor, but the sick, and that he had not come to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance. While the tax collectors and sinners were glad to hear Jesus and repent and follow him, the righteous Pharisees did not think they were sinners and that they had any need for repentance. They felt self-satisfied, justified before God, and so Jesus tries to show them he does not want to waste his time with them, while he can help others who are ready to receive help. He uses two illustrations to show this point. The first is the waste caused by using new cloth to repair old torn clothes, which only makes the tear worse. The second is the waste caused by putting new wine into old wineskins. If you do this, the wineskin will burst and the wine will be wasted. The proud Pharisees wanted to maintain their own righteousness and not accept the righteousness that comes from God. If Jesus spent his time with these old religious Pharisees, they would not repent and Jesus' teachings would be rejected. It would be a wasted effort, just as with the broken wineskins or the torn cloth. On the other hand, Jesus was glad to share with the tax collectors and sinners, for they were like new wineskins ready to receive new wine. They would gladly hear and repent, and Jesus' efforts would not be wasted. The new wine can be likened to Jesus' teaching, which the old wineskins, the Pharisees, were not ready to accept. Jesus said, "I have not come to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance." Luke chapter 5, verse 32.